Stocks are fluctuating and heading to the first monthly gain in 4 months. S&P edging closer to that 2100 level, a level that's been a tipping point for previous rallies. Well, back on February 11th, Tom DeMark, the founder and CEO of DeMark Analytics, appeared on Bloomberg Television and called for oil to rally off its 13-year lows. Crude's up 47% since then. And on February 23rd, DeMark called for the S&P to fall, but it's up 7% since then. Tom DeMark joins us now over the phone. Tom, thank you for joining us. What do you see now when it comes to the S&P? 2100, or are we revisiting those lows?
Well, it's always great to be with you, and thanks for the invitation. What I'd like to do is just indulge you for 1 minute. What we had identified a November 3rd high as well as the January 20th low and the February 11th low on the air all three times were the turning points in the market. We anticipated, because 90% of the stocks hit bottom on January 20th through February 11th, we thought it'd be a longer-term upside move. But what we did, we really strayed from the reservation in the sense that we didn't follow our indicators that the way we should have. And on February 22nd, we said the market was vulnerable to possibly a 5 to 10% correction. Mm-hmm. And the reason we said that was because we followed the Chinese markets and other worldwide markets very closely, and the Chinese market was vulnerable of a 10% move, and we said it could happen very quickly and aggressively, and it did. The Chinese market sold off 10%, whereas the U.S. market only sold off 3%. Mm-hmm. At that time, we saw the 2 days trading, we said to ourselves, the market's going to bottom on the futures at 1888, and it did bottom there. But unfortunately, interviews such as this and media interviews are really snapshots, and they're not motion pictures.
So we tried to undo
the damage, because like I said, we strayed from the reservation in that sense. We were going overseas at the time, and we labeled our tours the DeMark Apologia Tour, because we did deviate from our indicators. But currently, we're back in sync again, we feel, and we're very close to what we believe is a high.
So let's break down what you see now, because what you pointed out is that if you take a look at the S&P now, the rally that we're seeing versus the rally that we saw in October, they actually do look relatively similar. We had 16 higher closes back then and 17 higher closes now. So if you take a look at that chart, what are your indicators telling you?
Well, see, if you even look further between the two periods, the late August low through the October, early October low last year, there were four successively higher closes and then subsequently six successively lower closes. That same movement was witnessed back off the January low into February, four successively higher closes, six lower closes. So we were following that model very closely. We rallied 13%. Currently, we've rallied 14.5%. We've had 17 higher closes. We did decouple somewhat in the past 2 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
But nevertheless, we still are. Our work is showing us that the major market indices, the broad indices, which bottomed first in the January-February period and really accounted for that 90% expectation that stocks were going to go up, are really showing us right now that we could be making a top as early as today, provided we make a higher high today than yesterday's high, but more likely tomorrow that could happen. But it looks like because of the bottom was so widespread positive that the market, after a correction, could start up again.
Okay, so let's drill down for the correction part, Tom, real quick, because if you take a look at what happened, say, in October and now, after we hit that top in the early November, the S&P fell about 13% and to that February low. Are you anticipating that kind of decline once the market tops out?
We can't tell right now. This is unusual for us because we're very specific and precise in our forecast. We cannot tell. Probably we'll have a better idea early next week, but it looks like to us it could only be a 5% decline. Hmm. You know, that's the way it looks right now. Just a reset in the market and then potentially go higher. But it's not conclusive right now.
Interesting. The other thing that you tend to look at for an indicator is the Russell 2000, so looking at those small cap stocks.
Yes.
Taking a look at that chart, what kind of action do you expect there?
Well, we think the Russell could get as high as 112.52.
Okay.
We're currently at 111. So we got a percent or so upside. And that market is in the QQQs, for example. We've got a little more upside there, and we were looking at 110.70 possibly. So that's another, 1%. So I think in the next 2 days we still could go higher. But then I think we could exhaust this trend and then come down. I hate to be so vague on it because generally we're very specific. But right now this is an inflection point, but we don't know if it's a severe one or just a normal correction of 5.5%. If you recall off the The January 20th low, we were looking for a 7 to 8% rally, and it went exactly 7.8% on February 1st. We're looking for possibly the inverse of that, but a little bit less, maybe 5.5% pullback after we make the high.
So it does seem like it's a little murky right now in the market, yeah. But once we do get that pullback and then the rally resumes, do you expect us to blow out to new highs and really get out of a new range, or are we going to continue to be range bound?
We can't tell. That's the problem. This is unusual for us. We're very, like I said.
Why is it so hard, Tom? Why is it so hard right now to tell? What's so murky for you?
The decline in early 2016 was initiated at 2075, approximately. The close is 2078 in the S&P cash. If we were to break that level, then we can more conclusively project a decline that would be modest. If we don't break that level in the next couple of days, it could be more severe, but we want to monitor that, the relationship between the current market and the peak that we recorded on the December 29th, was around 2081, 2082. If we exceed that level, then I think that we should have a modest decline. If we don't reach that level on this move, it could be more serious, but more severe. But we can't tell just yet.
Tom, great to get your perspective on that. So, looking at potential 5% decline in the S&P after topping out either today or tomorrow, then the S&P potentially resuming its rally. But great to have you, Tom. Thank you very much for your perspective. Tom DeMark, founder and CEO of DeMark Analytics.